In this part, we will overview Rijia Sultana's reign. A historian, Peter Jackson, notes that the sources of Rijia's reign are relatively very limited. It is clear that not very much is written about Rijia's reign. Only one historian, the writer of Minhaj-e-Siraj, has recorded the events of the period, and he is rather elliptical. The remainder of the medieval sources, written sometimes a century or more after the events, produced greatly embellished versions of the story. A few events do emerge with relative clarity from Minhaj's account, as he notes that Rijia was the eldest daughter of Altutmash, a Delhi Sultan of 13th century who was Turkish. Altutmash intended for his eldest son Nasiruddin Mahmud, but after the son died prematurely of illness, the Sultan was obliged to make other plans. According to Minhaj, after returning from an expedition to Gwalior in 1233, the Sultan designated as his successor Rijia, the daughter of his chief wife Turkan Khatun. The history explains that Rijia exercised authority and possessed great grandeur, and because her father used to notice in her indications of sovereignty and high spirit, although she was a daughter and consequently veiled from public gaze, he commanded his secretary to write out a decree naming his daughter as his heir apparent, and she was made her heir. The designation was carried out over the complaints of his attendants, who maintained that he would not name his daughter as a successor when he had grown-up sons who were eligible for sovereignty. Minhaj also records that the Sultan, as responding that his sons were engrossed in the pleasures of youth and none of them possesses the capacity of managing the affairs of the country, whereas Rijia, his daughter, was the most worthy, as would be proven after his death. At a different point in the narrative, however, Minhaj conveys an expectation prevalent among the people that Rijia's half-brother, later known as Ruknuddin Firoz Shah, would succeed his father. Firoz Shah had been granted the Ikta of Lahore upon Altutmash's return from Gwalior, the same time that the Sultan apparently designated Rijia his successor. So it was basically the will of Sultan Shamsuddin Altutmash to make her daughter the successor of Delhi Sultanate. So the day after the Sultan's death on 21st Shaban, corresponding to April 30, 1236, the Maliks and the grandees of the kingdom by agreement seated Firoz Shah on the throne. His brother Timuless reign was dominated by his mother Shah Turkan, who ruled the kingdom while Firoz Shah occupied himself in buffoonery, sensuality and diversion. But when Rijia Sultana ascended the throne, Minhaj writes and observes that all things returned to their usual rules and customs, and after initial rebellions by some provincial governors and emirs who refused to acknowledge her, the kingdom became pacified and the power of the state widely extended. The historian writes that from Lucknow to Diwal and Damrila, that is from Western Bengal to Lower Sindh, all the Maliks and Amir manifested their obedience and submission to Rijia Sultana.